I'm in record mode.
Oh, what's on radio on? I hear you. Y'all high tech right now.
Not quite. Not quite.
Jim, I'm coming in behind you just a second. Let me set this down.
All right, go ahead. No problem. I got some time.
Did y'all was not, what do you call them things, buttony things, because they meant to each other? They are different.
The old days, that was always a problem. Yep. But the new electronics, yep. No problem.
It's got its own little thing.
Yes.
It's off. You know what, a megahertz, it won't bother it.
These are gigahertz.
Gigahertz, million hertz.
Yes, so they're really up there.
Again, I'm keeping full control of the surface again, 100%.
Okay, how much is this one?
269, was it? I think it was
269. That ain't too bad.
No.
You know, I thought these things was in the thousands.
Dude.
They've got some.
All right, well, this is my fear for them here.
It was the camera, not the prop. And it didn't hurt the plane. Twisted. It didn't hurt the plane. The camera popped off because I didn't have the I had the battery under but not looped, so the camera popped off of it. The ground is so soft, it just plugged the nose into the mud, and that's all it did. It didn't even hurt. Didn't hurt the wings. It did. It caused a twist in the rubber bands, but that's it. That's pretty good there.
It didn't set it down that hard.
No, it really didn't. It was almost. It was almost at stall speed. Yeah, that just popped loose there. That's easy. Yeah.
Real quiet, Jake.
Yeah.
Get the nose off of the fella.
Get the mud off of it. Added some weight to it. Yeah. But that's all it did. Yeah. Made a little mud on it.
That plane, they say that plane, I've seen guys on video crash the plane on purpose. I mean, just slam it into the ground and then it'll just slide offline.
What I had done
is I'd stuck it
under here like this, and I usually stick it under and then have it caught here.
Yeah.
And then that way, if the camera pops off, it can't go anywhere because this is too tight. Let's see if I've